Hey friends, it's Brian here and I'm working on the Jeep. I finally had a couple days off where things kind of slowed down after Memorial Day. I'm really grateful for it. I've worked really hard this spring and I have not had time to mess with this Jeep and it's been eating at me. So I finally got my welder going. I don't remember the last time I used it. Well, yeah, I do. It was when I built a fish tank stand. You can check that out on my videos. So anyway, here's what we got going on. I bought some material. It's about 5 millimeters thick. I've already done one weld here. That turned out good, considering I'm not sure the gas was flowing properly. I've done another little test weld. It's a little ugly. And I did a little bit more work in here. And I'm going to grind some of this out because, again, I'm not sure the gas was flowing right. And then I'm going to prep this spot. And I've already bent. Where'd it go? Oh, there it is. So I took, and crudely, I'm just going to build a reinforcement here. And it's not perfect, but it'll be okay. So I'm going to weld here. This will be a little tough, but I'm going to weld up here first. And then I'm going to clamp this down or bead it. Actually, I might just go unbend that a little bit. But then I'm going to just weld all the way around this, and this will double up the thickness here. There is a little crease in the frame. I don't like that. So, again, this material is just a hair thicker or thinner than what cheap Chrysler used. I mean, Jeep. Oh, did I say cheap? Yeah, I did. Fuck them. And then I'm going to build a... I'm going to reinforce this spot. And I'm going to reinforce it on the inside as well. I just want to beef up this section of the frame because this is where it took the abuse. And I think we're good to go. And we can start actually putting this damn Jeep together. It's been sitting here for a year. Anyway, let me go bend this and I'll be back. Okay, so I went in and I bent right here. And you can see this very nicely fits. I mean, I'm just kind of eyeballing it, but I'm getting it close enough that welding will bring it the rest of the way. The weld will be stronger than the parent metal, meaning this piece of metal and this piece of metal will be weaker than the pounds per square inch rating of the actual weld bead. And my general philosophy is build it so I never have to fuck with it again. And that generally means that I overbuild everything. So, whereas the factory thinks this is fine, I would have brought it down here and then I would have welded in there because that's just how I do shit. So anyway, let's get busy with it. And I'm going to put another little weld in here because I want to reinforce the shock tower. So I've got a little bit of grinding to do and I'm going to set the camera up where you guys can watch that and then I'm going to get busy with grinding. Bought a bucket of grinders back with me from the shed. Huh? Yeah, we'll abuse this one first because it's got a disc in it. I'm gonna need something to plug it into. I seem to have forgotten where the switch is. There we go. Man, where in the hell do I set everything? So I've got a helmet that has a grinder and a welder setting, so I've set it in weld. This is going to be a real pain in the ass to get into, so I'm going to pull the side handle off. Okay, really need a grinder without a guard on it because it's very difficult to get in here. So let me see what I've got in the bucket of chain. Hey, there we go. It's a DeWalt grinder that I've had two-thirds of forever that honestly needs a new cord. Alright, desperately needs a new cord. We'll put this one back together. Over there, take this one apart. Absolutely beautiful, makes really short work out of this. I think there's just a little bit more to go here, and I need to pull this out temporarily to get where I want to go. Wanted all the paint off, and I've got it off. Those discs are wonderful for this. Where the hell did I set it? I still see some paint in here, and I don't like that. I want that paint gone. Thought I had it gone, but I see there's just a little bit more down in here. Good enough for cheap ass work. Okay, so I'm using the magnet to hold things together. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here and I'm going to tack weld the top and the middle and this backside. And this is going to be a difficult weld because of access. If all this shit wasn't in my way, it would be a lot easier, but it is what it is. So let me get in here. Let me get set up for my weld. So fortunately my shop is air conditioned, or my garage is air conditioned. It makes it a lot more pleasant to work in here. I'm going to reposition the camera. right, moment of abuse, I mean truth. So we're gonna turn the thickness up to just the high side of 3/16, because that's approximately where this is. And then we'll see if we can get some good penetration and get some tack welds. Oh, before we do, let's set the mask to weld. It's a dual-purpose mask. Nothing magical, China's best. Shade. So I'm gonna see if that fixes it. That looks pretty good there. So now I'm gonna position myself somehow. All right, I'm gonna probably block the you all's view, but I need to get in here. It's not quite as tight as I'd like, so I'm gonna pause here and see if I can fix that with a clamp. I may have to go get one. I own a tremendous amount of welding equipment. It's been packed away since dirt was new. I just haven't had my shop set up, so I'm gonna go hunt for it. I'll be back. As promised, I have a whole bunch of clamps. I'm gonna take the largest one I own and see if it'll fit. Pull that down and get me a nice reinforcing bond, which is what we're looking for. I'm making a god-awful mess in my shop. It'll be okay. I'm gonna get it done. I'm tired of looking at my Jeep and watching other people drive theirs. Need this at this point. But we'll need it again soon. And position's the hardest thing on this weld. Ugly. I really need to be inside there. So let me work on that. OSHA violations for 300, please, Alex. Not work related.
Nope,
not at all. Alright, the tack holds it in place. Let's see if I can get you guys a little better camera angle. Alright, I think that's a pretty good camera angle right there. Alright, I got a bunch of shit in the way. So, my cat believes that the Jeep is its perch. One of my cats does. And he's been pulling these wires down where they're in my way. All right, that should be good right there. Sorry, you're gonna get some dead air here, but you know, if you watch my videos, you're probably used to that by now. I'd like it a little bit taller. That looks really nice. Can't really see what's going on down there. I need to go get a flashlight. I'll be back. All right, so overall this looks pretty good. Nice thick bead. I'd like a little bit better. I can't really see. Ain't going nowhere, that's for sure. Oh yeah, that's fine. Plenty of penetration. I've got to get up under this part here, so I'm gonna work on that, and then I'm done on the inside. Ah, damn it, my helmet's on the other side there. All right, so we're gonna work on this spot right here. Can't get in here. All right, let me put myself in a really dangerous spot. Having a good welder sure makes short work of this. So when I said earlier, let me put myself in a dangerous position, what I was referring to is I had my leg in between pieces of the Jeep. And that's just not a safe place. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do though, and that was one of those times. Beautiful piece. Normally I'd like to weld longer, but I'm having trouble seeing through this shade. Welded compared to anything anybody else is gonna do. But that's the Brian way. Shit's stronger than it was when I started. Alright, so I need to take the paint off of this area because I am gonna put a splice plate in along here. And I also need to take this excess metal off and re-weld that with proper gas coverage. So we'll start here. All right, well, we'll start with taking off the paint. It's not pretty, but it's okay. So I could easily do a foot long piece here. All right, so we've got the piece of metal cut and prepped. We've got the sanding done and we're fixing to get after this. I don't know if this is really necessary, but my senses tell me it is, so I'm gonna do it. And it's also not gonna hurt anything. We want this one. This is going to get a little bit tricky here. Yeah, there we go. Not so tricky after all. But we are just going to wedge this in place. I'll clamp it. Same thing. Climb back inside to set this one. I'm going to use one with a I'm going to use one with a foot on it. So I think we are ready to go on this one. Tack, 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 tack. And then that's going to be difficult to get. I'll have to get that from the inside. In there and just a hand strength issue. I don't have the hand strength to do it from the inside where it was. Oh yeah, that was a shitty weld. I mean, it's tacked, but that's putting it nicely. You know, there is an issue there. Let me see if I can fix that. Seems like my tension's off. there, and there. Pretty, but it's functional, and that's what's going to happen. So I need to reinforce some other areas here. Okay, so I've got a little bit of rework here. I need to grind, and then I need to repair this. I don't know what the fuck happened here, but whatever it is, it needs to be patched, so I'm going to put a big ass patch on it. Really, this should be sectioned, but I think it can be patched and it'll be okay. I'm almost tempted to cut this out and patch along here, but I think I can get away without doing that. And this actually carries the weight, so from here back is structural, from here forward is not so much structural. So I mean, honestly, it's, if I put a plate here and wrap it, I think it'll be okay. And that's what I'm fixing to do. So I'm gonna take some measurements and get to fabricating. All right, so this is probably the most serious repair that's getting made. But again, the weight is carried on the spring. Actually, the weight is carried right here, but it'll be fine when I'm done. This is probably the hardest part, is getting up in here, and I really need more light. after a brief unscheduled break, I have more welding wire, which turns out to be what was wrong. So, no big deal. So, I'm anticipating that it will weld a whole lot better now that it has wire. Now, in the past, I used the INE brand from Amazon, and after brief but careful consideration, I decided that the Vulcan brand from Harbor Freight would probably not be a whole lot different, so that's what I bought. And we're gonna get after this and see if we can get it done. Seems to be very, very similar. Let me get this clamp out of the way. I meant to set that down. Just not like that. So I'm gonna dress the edges of these real quick. Damage to the frame is in this section right here. So let's verify that this is indeed 20 inches. It is not. So let's check the other piece. It is not. So it looks like we miscut the material that we had. That's annoying. We got turned around. 16 and 16.5. So that's kind of irritating. I was really hoping for a 20 inch long piece, but let's see how this is going to work. Yeah, it really needs to be longer. I can't believe I just did that. Let me see what else I got. So I should have cut on this mark and I cut on that mark, and that's completely my fault, my fuck up. So I shortened the piece. I have a piece that's 18 inches long. So I've got a couple options here. Most sense. I'm going to leave this part alone. There is a small dent here, which means there's probably some deformation on this side, but this is a relief point for the frame, so I'm going to leave it alone. And I'm going to trim this down just a little bit as part of my fitting piece process. Actually, you know, I'm not going to mess with that. I'm just going to go ahead and start the bending process. Let me go bend this. I'll be back. So, I wasn't able to get the purchase on it that I needed. My bench vise just isn't mounted sturdy enough, and I was going to rip the bench up, which honestly wouldn't be the end of the world. Bench has seen way better days. But so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bend it on frame with clamps. I have an abundance of these big clamps, so it shouldn't be a big deal. All right, so we basically got this in here where we want. Now what I'm going to do is kind of shift gears. I'm going to use a paint marker because I need to scribe the inside edge here so I know where to trim this. So for all my armchair experts who will suddenly come out of the woodwork when they in the comments, my theory is that while Jeep, Dodge, Fiat, Stellantis, Mercedes-Benz, and everybody else who took a piss at the factory and called themselves an engineer says you should not use heat, you should not use sectioning, and you should not weld to the frame. Okay, I think their lawyer wrote that process, because, or the salespeople, because the reality of it is that these things rust out faster than a nail in the ocean. And people constantly weld shit to these, and it doesn't do anything to it. Now, this is admittedly a critical point, but the worst case that will happen is it'll get thrown away and replaced. Perhaps this one will be easier for me to remember where I'm saving and what I'm not saving. But anyway, I am firmly convinced that what I'm doing will not harm the Jeep, and I'm willing to take the risk. In fact, I think it'll be just fine. Given the option, I probably would have gone from here to here, but I don't feel like rebuilding the entire goddamn frame. So, yeah, fuck it. In order to be able to weld in my garage anywhere I want, I have a plug with a big ass extension cord. And you know what? That's not gonna work. I don't want to come that close to. This will work just fine. It would be exceptionally nice to have a workbench again, but I don't. So here we are. So I think we're ready to cut along this line and see if we can avoid screwing up this piece of material. And, you know, this has been delayed for a long time because I needed to be in the damn mood. I needed to be in a mood where I was ready to work on this and work through things like this where it doesn't go the way I expect it to. And it's okay. I mean, this is what repair is a bunch of improvisation. So, speaking of improvisation, let's see if we pop a circuit breaker again. Thank you. So we're basically there. Oh, I need to prep the inside of this. Thank you. some of that while I set up. That by welding this scab over here, I am defeating the crumple zone on the front of this, and that's fine. I'm not worried about the crumple zone. Crumple zone is already crumpled. Practices for metal forming, but it does get this in here. Let me show you what we're working on. So, got nice. It's not perfect, but it's pretty tight. So that'll work. I followed on every other weld today. I'm going to tack it and then I'm going to seam it. welds. Too much heat. Sorry, there ain't no better way to do this. Understand, it's acting like it's flux core. right. I just wanted to let some of the foul air out of here. But I'm done repairing the frame on the Jeep, finally. A little bit of touch-up to do with the grinder to make it suitable to meet my standards. I'm going to touch this up a little bit, and then call it a night. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please follow along. Remember to like and subscribe to my video. And have a great night. It's a 40 grit disc. It'll pull some material off there pretty quickly. All right. And again, you know, this is a stiffener plate. Its goal is to reinforce the frame rail right here. There's one. Alright, so we need something in the center here. All right, so we're good to tack it in place, but I still want this to come in. And I'm gonna have to do that probably in a separate pull. And if need be, I could close it, but I wanna get it right. So we're going to clamp to the frame here. Good. First. This is the hardest part. Finish the bottom. Spot, and I'm making that bend.
said I was going to do the bottom because this is the hardest one part. No. Good enough? Yep. I've got a little twist right here, and I'm debating if I want to scab the frame right here, even though this is an energy absorption point. Pretty solid. I've got one little spot here that didn't get welded. Okay, this is a Brian thing. It's not a required. So I've got this one little half inch gap, and that bothers the shit out of me. So I'm gonna suit back up and weld it. And oh, while I'm here, so I've got just a little bit of a deformation right here, and so I think I'm gonna go ahead and just scab the frame because I got the material. I'm out here. I'm dirty. I'm fucking with all of it. So yeah, fuck it. Let's just do it. Held it. Yeah, there it is. seriously doubt that that mattered to anybody but me. So part of the reason I'm aggressively scabbing the frame is that I just don't have a whole lot of confidence in this frame. It's a lot worse than I thought it was when I bought it. And to be honest, had I seen the crinkly cuts on this, all the crinkling on this frame, I wouldn't have bought this Jeep. I just wouldn't have. But, you know, I'm already married to it, so might as well see how it plays. Of mistake past. Thank you. that's what keeps happening to these. They keep falling off. And being ruined. Thank you.